I'm going to talk about three mistakes that you can easily avoid during campus placements as a beginner. So let's get started. Yo, what's going on guys? Tanmay here for Simple Snippets, and in this video, I'm gonna talk about three common mistakes that we as beginners do in our campus recruitment process. Now, I know a lot of campus placements have already begun in your colleges. If you're a final year student, you guys must be facing some campus placements. And if you're a fresher, this video is definitely a must watch because I'm gonna talk about three important and serious mistakes that we do as beginners. So make sure you watch this video till the end. Now, the number one mistake that we do as a beginner is we do not focus much on academics. Yes guys, academics do matter a lot, but there is two different sides to this issue. So when I say two different sides, I'm gonna say that academics matters a lot in certain perspectives, but academics doesn't matter a lot in some other perspectives. So let's see what this actually means. So when a company comes for placements in colleges, in campus placements, what it does is it has a minimum criteria. And this is kept because they want to filter out a lot of students. Because then we know that for two job placements, there are like 100-200 applicants, right? And a company cannot interview all of them. So they come with an eligibility criteria, which is kind of like 65% throughout or 7-pointer GPA out of 10 or 6.5 or something like that. So if you're a beginner and if you are in college degree and if you're not focusing much on academics, your percentage or your GPA will fall down and then you will not be eligible for some companies. Yes guys, this is a sad fact, I know, and trust me, even I do not want this to happen, and I'm not a fan of companies keeping this criteria because anyways they're gonna conduct their own aptitude process as well, right? So why keep one extra thing to filter out students? But then this is the hard fact that you guys need to understand, and this is more specific if you guys are just starting off your degree, be it bachelor's, be it master's, if you are a computer science or IT student. Just understand that you need to maintain a good academic score. And when I say good, it is not that you have to be the absolute best. You don't need to be a university topper. You just need to have a basic criteria. And this is specifically to Indian institutes. What happens is the criteria for campus placements by majority of the companies is around 70%. Okay, so make sure you score above 70% or at least above 65%. And if it is a GPA system for you, which is out of 10, just try to maintain 7-pointer and above. Okay, because majority of the companies, MNCs have a criteria which says that throughout 65% or throughout 70% or throughout CGPA of 6.5 and above. Okay, so please make sure that you maintain academics at least above average. Now, initially, I also said that academics do not matter in certain perspective. So what is that? Let me explain. Now, let's say you are eligible for the companies and you have scored average percentage or average CGPA. Let's say your CGPA is 7 and you're pretty much eligible for all other companies. Now, you don't need to put in extra efforts just for the academics, because for a company, a 9-pointer student is equal to a 7-pointer student if he or she is eligible. So if you meet the basic eligibility criteria, you don't have to be a topper, because you're not going to get special privileges by a company, because ultimately they're going to carry out their own aptitude process. They're going to carry out their own HR process, their technical interview and whatnot. So they see you as equal. So you putting that extra efforts just to score high marks is not gonna be that value when it comes to placement perspectives. Instead, what I would recommend is you put that extra time and effort into creating a live project or working for some company, doing some internship, getting some certifications done. That will add a lot of value. So note this point that I'm telling you. A person having a basic criteria, eligibility criteria, let's say 7.5 pointer or 75%, and having a couple of internships or maybe a couple of live projects or some freelance work is of much higher value to any company compared to a person who is a university topper having a 9-pointer or 95%. Okay, so keep this in mind. Try to optimize your academics. You don't have to be a topper, but you don't have to go beyond or below that particular level also. So this was mistake number one, which you guys need to avoid. Do not be very bad at academics. Be an average or above average student. Let's move on to the next common mistake that you guys need to avoid. Now, I know a lot of you guys have already done the mistake number one, and maybe you are into final placements, final years, and you cannot do a lot about your academic score. But this next tip is something which you can definitely avoid. Now, this mistake is having a bad resume or a bad CV. Now, I'm not going to explain what is a resume, what is a CV, what's the difference. We can have a complete separate video on that. But basically, your resume is a first impression of you to the company. So even before you guys actually physically come in front of the interviewer, your resume is already being judged by them. So do not take a resume lightly, and there are many do's and don'ts which you can easily Google out, and we can have a separate video tutorial completely on how to write a resume, what are the do's and don'ts. If you want that video, let me know in the comments. But some basic resume do's and don'ts are, do not put something that you've not done. Now, if you've not done any project and if you're not confident about a particular technology, please do not put it in your resume. That is definitely going to be negative if the interviewer asks you and if you're not able to answer it. Some things that you don't need to do is do not put a lot of achievements which are not technical. For example, if you are your college intra winner, you don't have to put all the winning things and you don't have to mention that you are a first runner up or you are second or you are first in table tennis, because a company is not really interested in hiring a person who is good at table tennis. A company is more interested in hiring someone who is good at technology and who's worked in some technology and done some project. So focus on putting out content which is going to be more important to a company. Okay. Having said that, I'm not saying you need not put anything in the extracurriculars, but focus on something that will add value to a company. Okay. For example, if you've worked on some project, you can definitely put them under the projects tab. You can create a separate section of projects or live projects or past experience if you have any, and that would add a lot of weightage. Okay. So that's very important. Another small tip to avoid having a bad resume is try to put something unique which is unique to yourself, because when you are applying for campus placements, understand that there are 100 other students who are applying for the same. And if you just see the educational background, pretty much all the 100 students will have kind of the same educational background, right? So how will your resume be unique to an interviewer, to a company, is what you need to focus on. Okay, so that in order to stand out from the crowd, you have to add something unique to it. So yeah, this was mistake number 2, which you definitely need to avoid. Do not have a bad resume, do not have a shabby resume. And again, we can have a separate video as I mentioned. Let's move on to the mistake number 3, which is probably one of the most important one of this video. And you really need to think on it, because we don't really think of it as a mistake. So mistake number 3 is not doing any company research. Yes guys, this is very serious. If a company is coming in, make sure you guys study that company, whatever technologies they are using, who is the CEO, what is the stock price of that company, who's your senior working in that company, and everything about that company. Because let's say in the interview, the interviewer asked you, why do you want to work for this so-and-so XYZ company? And if you're unable to answer that basic question, the interviewer will have that perception that you're not really interested in working for that company, right? Because if you cannot answer a basic question that why do you want to work for XYZ company, then it gives a very negative impression and you might get eliminated just because of this one question. So doing a very thorough company research before the company comes in is very, very important. Go ahead on their website, go ahead on Google and type in the company name. Let's say Infosys is coming in, just type in Infosys latest news. See who is the latest CEO, CFO and all the top level employees. Make a list of all the new technologies that that particular company is working on. Let's say it's working on artificial intelligence and it is of your interest. And in the interview, if they ask, why do you want to join this company? You can mention that I read that Infosys recently acquired this new company which works on artificial intelligence. I would really like to work in that division. I'm really excited about it. If you just say this statement, the interviewer will be actually surprised in a very positive way. He or she will be like, okay, this guy has really studied about our company. He knows a lot of things and he definitely is genuinely interested. So this is very, very, very important. And I don't think a lot of you guys do a proper company research. And this needs to be done on pretty much all the companies that are coming in for campus placements. So yeah, these were the 3 mistakes that we as a beginner would make, and this would result in our elimination from interview process. And I know interviews are daunting and you guys are already worried. But don't worry, make sure you keep these 3 important tips in mind. And I do have few more tips. So if you want those, let me know in the comments that you want a part 2 of this video. So maybe I can make a part 2 and guide you through more tips and avoid some more mistakes. So that's it for this video guys. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you are new on this channel, I make a lot of technology oriented videos, programming tutorials, computer science oriented tutorials and campus recruitment process tutorials just like this one. So subscribe and stay notified. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.